Now, you shot for Terry Richardson.
Yes, I did.
How was that?
It was really fun. We just did a really quick shoot because I was in New York at the time performing at, I can't remember which club I was performing at on that trip. I think it might have been Show Palace or something. It was a strip club. And so I had some time to kill, and we'd been talking about shooting together for a while. So we just did like a really quick little thing.
I mean, very famous photographer.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I feel very lucky to have worked with him.
What'd you think of the shoot?
It was really fun. It was really relaxed because it wasn't for anything other than ourselves. So we were just having fun.
But the pictures came out.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Now, you know, he had some, you know, drama associated with him with like sexual assault allegations mm-hmm. and stuff like that. But what are your thoughts on all that?
Well, I can't really say because I don't know what happened personally. Mm-hmm. All I know is from what I know of him, who he's a very nice, respectful guy. He didn't try anything with me. And you'd think he would, as being the crazy porn star that I am, that maybe he would have. But he was very nice and respectful. And I think, you know, whatever happened, you know how things can get twisted and warped and hearsay. So I don't really know. But
I mean, there is a lot of truth, you know, behind sort of the sleazy, you know, camera, you know, photographer, cameraman kind of thing. You know, I've heard a lot of stories from a lot of different girls, especially in the urban modeling mm-hmm. world.
I mean, I'm not denying he's a pervert. I mean, I'm a perv too. And he actually came and photographed me on set of a kink.com shoot that I did. Okay. So, I mean, that I'm not denying that he's a little perverted, but I mean I can't say because I wasn't right there. And
I feel you. Now, you've done some mainstream modeling also. You posed for Louis Vuitton.
Yeah, it was a shoot for ID magazine, and they had all of these crazy beautiful bags and shoes for us. The shoot was actually nude more than anything else, but I got to pose with, so it was like a $30,000 bag that they only made 8 of in the world.
Oh, so was it for Louis Vuitton or was it for ID magazine?
It was for ID magazine.
Oh, okay, but it was just Louis Vuitton. Yeah. But you did American Apparel.
Yes.
Okay, that was for an actual ad.
Yes. Well, that was again for a print thing.
A print thing. Yeah. Oh, so it wasn't like
it
an
was
ad.
It was like a magazine. That was years and years ago. Okay. That was before I even did porn.
I mean, do you feel that, you know, when you do porn, you could break out and do more mainstream stuff, or do you feel that it kind of puts a stigma on you?
I think that it definitely really, really did in the past. I think doors are kind of opening these days just because the world is becoming so much more open-minded and accepting of, I mean, especially in the gay lesbian community, the fact that Tiffany's just did an ad campaign featuring two men getting married, which is a huge step forward. Yeah. I saw it posted online somewhere. I think it was two guys or two girls.
I mean, it's actually kind of interesting now with a company like Tiffany.
Yes.
You know, which is a super conservative, mm-hmm. you know, very overpriced. You know, I mean, like they have to maintain a certain exclusivity to mm-hmm. charge the type of prices they do for, you know, I mean, things that you could actually get much cheaper. You know, like a Tiffany diamond is like 3 times the cost of a regular diamond.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Huh, yeah, interesting.
Sure. And I also think that because social media has enabled the general public to see how celebrities or porn stars or whoever, see how they live on their day-to-day lives, it's allowing people to really realize that, yes, all these people are real human beings. We're not, just because someone does adult work doesn't mean that they're crazy drug addicts. Yes, their stereotypes exist for a reason, but you can't pigeonhole people.